Departing from the Great Bridge of Murden, the Alliance Army marches south toward Envar, the Imperial capital. As an unknown military force begins their advance under the banner of the Kingdom, the Imperial Army dispatches forces from Fort Mercius with the intention of intercepting them. The curtain is rising on a conflict between the three armies, which will come to be known as the Battle at Gronder, held on the same plains that witnessed the Battle of the Eagle and Lion.
Know that I will tear your heads from your shoulders. The dead must have their tribute.
As big class reunions go, this one's gotta be the worst in history.
Years ago, we fought here as classmates. But not today.
Kill every last one of them!
And so we fight on.
I will crush anyone who blocks my path.
Dimitri, he's alive. But he doesn't look interested in joining forces with us.
It would not be advantageous to take on both at once. We must stop the Kingdom and the Alliance from joining forces. I will create such chaotic warfare that they won't be able to tell who is friend and who is foe.
Your service. Let's make this quick.
Let's clean up. I'll crush them all.
What's my strategy?
Time to slow down.
At the ready.
Shall we? I will prevail.
My orders?
I'll cut through.
Mounted units, advance! Enemies in the central area. We need to head there immediately to protect it. Not for myself, for everyone.
I fought and won.
Thank you. but it's you or me.
Starting to crumble. We will step on the Empire right along with the Alliance troops. To the eternal flames with all of them!
We all choose our paths, and I've chosen mine. I fight for my lord to the death.
I guess this is fate. Sorry, but I need you to please give up quietly, okay?
All is fair in war.
Strategy.
People are waiting on me.
To slack off.
Back.
must lead them well.
Allow me to demonstrate!
There's no turning back now.
Here is something to believe in!
This could turn the tides. Not my best.
Allow me to demonstrate!
It won't be in vain.
Maybe this will help me keep steady.
Make a difference?
Another victory. Fitting outcome.
Those fools who went up the hill will pay with their lives in the Crimson Flames.
The central hill is up in smoke. Suppose I'll have to quench the flames with the enemy's blood.
Ah!
but it's you or me.
Are you trying to stop me too? I'll just have to kill you! Watch and learn!
All is going to plan.
Let's clean up.
Going for the kill!
My orders?
Who's next?
What's my strategy? I must lead them well.
I will prevail.
Witness Bridget Pride!
At the ready.
Fought and won.
Ghost.
I'll try.
Crush them all.
Fighting is what I do.
At your service. Yeah! Let's make this quick.
Central Hill is up in smoke.
You're not worth it. Get out of my sight. Where are you, Ape God? I will not stop until I kill you!
Thank you.
shall we?
I'll cut through.
Can't afford to slack off.
Sorry, but I must.
All right, next.
In the name of His Highness, you die here.
Here is something to believe in!
I...
Good idea. Won't hold back.
Feels good to fight for a cause.
You fought well.
We're interfering with the plan. Looks like I'll just have to get rid of you. Fighting on will endanger my life. Your Majesty, I must withdraw.
No need to worry. We still have some troops left. So long as I stand, we won't give up.
Thank you.
die yet. I'm not there yet.
No turning back now.
Good form.
One to remember. Stronger, faster, never enough.
Thank you.
Ah, thanks.
Destroy both the kingdom and the alliance. Now, with one fell swoop. I lost. Just as expected, you aren't making my path an easy one. I must retreat for now. We'll meet again on the battlefield.
Even in an ugly battle like this, it's important not to lose heart. We have to take pride in our victory. We did it, Teach. Now we can move forward to our victory! So, Edelgard retreated. I suppose she lives to be defeated another day. Too close. But I suppose all that matters is that we won. Some of our allies are injured but can still fight. We'll just have to accept this outcome and press onward. Still, the battlefield looks awful. And I wonder what became of the Kingdom Army and Dimitri.
I saw him.
Who? Dimitri?
He was completely different from how I remember him. He looked like a crazed demon while he was fighting. He pursued Edelgard as she retreated, but he didn't get far before he collapsed. I saw him surrounded by Imperial troops and pierced by their spears. I'll never forget it. He deserved a better end.
Dimitri. He went through so much to make it here, only for his efforts to be in vain.
I can't even begin to understand what Dimitri must have been feeling, but there must have been some other way. Why did he have to go like that?
And his vassal, Dedu, did he fall as well?
I don't know.
Your Highness, your ambitions are my own now. I will bring you Edelgard's head. I swear it!
Professor? Claude? May I have a moment of your time?
Lysithia, what are you doing up this late? Trouble sleeping? Anyone would be shaken after such a brutal battle. If you're having trouble sleeping, you should drink some warm milk. That's a thing, right?
Must you treat me like a child, simply because I'm awake a bit later than usual? Actually, I can hardly muster any indignation right now. I wanted to tell you that I noticed something odd during that battle.
What was it?
There were some strange mages among the ranks of the Imperial Army. Did you notice them? That's right. I have seen people dressed just like that before. It was a long time ago. House Ardelia was involved in a rebellion that took place within the Empire 18 years ago. After it was quelled, all of the key officials were caught and put to death. The Empire sent replacements, who they used to take control of House Ardelia. Among the people sent by the Empire were mages dressed in black, just like those we saw in battle.
If they're Imperial mages, it makes sense that they would wear the same clothing, right?
Yes, but the mages from back then and today, I do not believe they are from the Dresdian Empire. No, I got the impression that they were from somewhere else, somewhere completely separate from Fodlan. There's more. Those mages imprisoned the children from my house and performed horrible rituals on them. Blood experiments.
Lysithia, you can't mean... even you?
Yes.
All of the others were deemed failures. They all died. And even I... It doesn't matter. The point is that those monsters possess dreadful knowledge and power. I just thought you should know the sort of people who have allied with the Empire.
Blood experiments. Does that remind you of anything, Teach? Exactly. There was that secret group who abducted Flayne and extracted her blood 5 years ago. The people involved back then were Tomas and Monica. Well, I suppose their true names were Solon and Kranya. So, that eerie group has been slithering behind the scenes in the Empire for a while now. Lysithia, thank you for sharing all of that with us. One day we will uncover the truth of who those people really are. We've managed to invade Empire territory and emerge victorious in our first battle. I hope to maintain our momentum and push onward to Enbar, the Imperium. Unfortunately, we are not legendary heroes in a fairy tale. Our stamina has limits. The longer we fight, the harder the fight will become. It will take immense effort to secure the supplies and soldiers we need to prevail.
Boy, you better not be saying this is as far as we go.
Of course not. However, the road ahead leads deep into enemy territory. It'll be a difficult journey, strewn with hardship. I can't guarantee that we'll make it out alive. If anyone wants to leave, now is the time to do it.
I shall accompany you to the very end. After all, someone must step up to take leadership should you fall.
I'm coming. The future of my village depends on this. Besides, I have to protect the professor. For Captain Gerald.
I'm not going anywhere. Because of the Empire, my little sis can't live in peace.
We can't leave the future of Fodlan to others. I'm sure that everyone here feels the same.
The Knights of Seros will keep fighting the Empire. We won't rest until we rescue Lady Rhea.
I feel the same as the Knights. I've got to rescue Lady Rhea no matter what.
So what? We're all supposed to take turns saying we'll do our best until the very end? And what about you, Marianne? What will you do?
I'll fight too.
Fine. I suppose I'll tag along too, until the bitter end.
It's an honor to keep fighting alongside such stalwart allies. Right, Teach? I know I'm a great leader and all, but praising me isn't gonna get you anywhere. All right. Now that I know where each of you stands, I'm going to return to Alliance territory for a while. I intend to report this victory to the Alliance lords and draw out even more support from them. Our next battle will be even more challenging, so brace yourselves for that.
I should write to my brother. He'll want to hear about our victory.
Your brother, Lord Holst? How is he these days?
Oh, he's doing great. I even got a letter from him before the last battle. He wanted to come and join our fight, too.
What's this? Lord Holst come here? That would be a most reassuring development.
Sadly, it sounds like my father was against the idea. They want him to stay in case they need to fight the Almirans.
Their logic is sound, though it is vexing that the Alliance's greatest general cannot join us on the front lines.
We should be glad that Holst is staying behind. Almira aside, there's also no guarantee that the Imperial forces won't try to launch a surprise attack from the Old Kingdom territory.
If you have something you need to talk to my brother about, I'd be happy to send a letter.
No, that's okay. I'm just glad to hear he's doing well. Please send him my regards.